Hello. Today we're launching a new series here on Norse Gaming, and it's Mountain Blade Bannerlord. This game has been out for a while, still in early access, and is on some points similar to Warlord Britannia, especially controlling armies and combat and stuff. So I hope you guys enjoy this series, and let's begin.
Norse Gaming.
Okay, so the first thing we need to do is to start a new campaign, and we're gonna create our own new character. So this is a strategy game, and I really love it.
For 500 years, the Calradian Empire dominated the continent. Its armies scattered foes before them. The strongholds of proud tribes crumbled beneath its engines of war. From the forests of the north to the wastes of the south, all was brought beneath the standard of their legions. Brutal as the conquest was, the wise agreed that it brought peace. The land, now untroubled by armies, grew rich. But empires, like men, grow old. Leaders lose a common cause. Corruption spreads. Old enemies learn the Empire's tricks and devise new ones of their own. Until one day, the bonds holding the Empire snap. Then comes the Civil War, pitting all against all. A time of hatred. A time of suffering. But also, even in the worst hours, a time of courage and defiance. As new leaders arise from new places and new peoples, to turn back the tides of destruction and bring forth a new world from the ashes of the old.
This is going to be fun. Okay, so we need to choose a culture. Just going to click through them fast so you can stop the video and learn all about them. But I have already decided that the Sturgeons will be our culture. Armies lose 20% less daily cohesion. Recruiting and upgrading infantry troops are 25% cheaper. That is very nice to have. And 20% more relationships penalty from kingdom decisions.
To hell with you!
So we're gonna go through all of this in the game. First we need to create our own character. I think that sounds fine. Oh, a little bit over medium height, I think. Weight, build, normal, less face depth. think that is good. Eyebrow depth. Eye size. Say nose angle. Yes, that looks okay. So it's a lot of customizations you can do to your character. It's very deep customization. And like I said, this game is still in early access, but the developers have come a long way to get this game finished. So I don't know if they're going to add in more cities or things in the future, but I hope so, and I also think that they're going to continue updating this game. Okay, you were born into a family. Now we're going to choose our story. So we will choose the three farmers. As a child, you were noted for your leadership skills. That's a good one. Like all village children, you helped out in the fields. You also repaired projects. As a youngster growing up in Calradia, war was never too far away. You trained with the infantry. Before you set out for a life of adventure, your biggest achievement was you invested some money in land. Like many families in Calradia, your life was ended by war. Your home was ravaged by the passage of army after army. Eventually, you sold your property and set off with your father, mother, brother, and your two younger siblings to a new town you'd heard was safer, but you did not make it. Along the way, the inn at which you were staying was attacked by raiders. Parents were slain and your two youngest siblings seized, but you and your brother survived because... So what will we choose here? Maybe you organize the travelers to break out. I think we're going for this one. Okay, our name. I've been thinking a lot about this. So it's going to be Bjorn. We're gonna play with the easy difficulty. This game is hard enough as it is, so. Okay. We're just gonna skip the tutorial. Don't want to get you bored by the long tutorial of this game, so. If you play it, you can go through it if you want. You can learn a thing or two. But for this series, we don't need it, so. A few hours after you leave the training ground, you come across a wounded man lying under a tree. You share your water with him and try to dress his wounds as best as you can. He tells you he is a traveling doctor. To thank you for your help, he hands you a small bronze artifact, which he says was once given to him in payment by a warrior who said only that it was related to Neretra's folly. He suspects it might be of great value. You resolve to find out more. Okay, this is a quest line we're eventually is going to follow. So our family name is of course Ironside. We're going to be Bjorn Ironside. Now we need to create our own banner. Maybe an X. Let's just see through the different kinds here. These are pretty cool. Looks like some Viking symbols. This one, perhaps. Some runes, maybe. Maybe this one. With the black flag and golden symbol. Yeah, I like the black better. Okay. We have our banner, and let's take a look at the gigantic world of this game. So all of the cities you can see here is the big cities, and when we zoom a lot closer, there are some small cities. So now, they're just us here, and we have some active quests. This is just to establish our clan, and this is the quest we were talking about with the doctor and the artifact we got. So now, the first thing we need to do, we have 1,000 gold. We need to recruit some soldiers. Only one here to recruit, cost 15 gold. And we also need to pay for upkeep. And the first easiest thing to do in this game is just to start trading. So we're gonna buy some mules. That means we can carry heavier loads. We can also sell the mules for a higher price. So this is what we need to do in the beginning of the game to get a lot of cash. Because gold in this game is everything. So we need a decent amount of troops just to keep raiders away. And we need to start trading a lot. So this game is going to have a bit of a slow start, but it will pay off in the end. And our goal is, of course, to become a king and own every settlement in the game. But we have a long road ahead to manage that. So I like this starting location because it is a lot of horse producers and mule producers, so you can get a lot of carrying animals early game. That way we can get a lot more of trading goods and travel around the map and sell them. So the game works like in an area with no horses, for example, you can get a lot more for your horses. And the whole economy is alive, so if someone have traded a bunch of horses in that region, the price will go down. I'm gonna buy some grain because we also need food in this game. For us and for our soldiers. Let's see here if there are some good wood we can buy. But first, let's recruit a couple of guys. Let's see. Yeah, this is very cheap. Hardwood. We're gonna buy a lot. Almost don't have any money left. But we're gonna be fine. So we're gonna buy 64 hardwood. gonna wait here a little time because I'm worried about the raiders. They had 15 men waiting outside for us. So we're gonna move a little bit east maybe. Want to get in a conflict with them just yet, but they fled when they saw the 83 army. Okay, here you can see we get 51 for the first hardwood we sell, and the price drops dramatically when we sell more. But remember, we paid 3 gold per hardwood, so this is a lot of profit. Not gonna sell anymore because we can get a lot more than 20 gold for hardwood. And we're just going to travel to the next city. After we gain some gold, we can also buy more men and start attacking looters and gain more and more power. Okay guys, this is all we had time for in this episode. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.